I'm Mordechai Torchiner with Beit Midrash Zichron Dov, and welcome to our Daily Dose videos on the Yom Tov of Sukkot. This video is dedicated by Francis and Moshe Goldstein and their families, with love in the memories of their parents, Rabbi Alexander and Susan Goldstein, whose families were everything. Sukkot is normally cast as a time of proximity to God. As the Torah tells us in Parshat Emor, Kiva Sukkot Hoshavti et Bnei Yisrael, when we sit in the Sukkah, we're supposed to remember Hashem put us in Sukkot. Whether that refers to huts or whether that refers to clouds of protection, on our way from Egypt into Israel, when we were in the Midbar, when we were in the wilderness, they refer to God protecting us. The Ramah, in his Torah Ta'olah, says that the Sukkot are supposed to represent the Av Ha'anan, the thick cloud with which God protected us. The Zohar on Parshat Emor goes even further and says that Sukkot are supposed to be like Tzel HaShechinah, the protective shadow of Hashem's manifest presence. And that's the way I learned about Sukkot when I was growing up. It was a holiday celebrating divine protection. At the same time, there are those who view Sukkot as a time of remoteness. There's a medrash in the Psikta de Rav Kahana which says the following, Shema Yetzei Dinam Shel Yisrael LeGalut. In case the Jews are judged that they should receive exile on Yom Kippur, we take care of it on Sukkot. Al yedei kein hein osin sukkah v'golin mibatehem lasukkah. We make a sukkah and we exile ourselves from our house to the sukkah in case we are supposed to experience exile so that we should have this gentler form of exile instead of a rougher form of punishment. So what we're actually doing when we sit in the sukkah is not getting closer to God, but distancing ourselves. We're supposed to be feeling we've been kicked out. We're in exile. Unless one say, well, you can find a medrash that says pretty much anything. Listen to the Maharil, one of the founding sages and halachic authorities of Ashkenazi Jewry, writing centuries ago, in which he said, Otam tziva mitzvat sukkah, another reason why God told us to do sukkah, samuch liyom ha-kippurim, close to Yom Kippur. After all, the Sukkot and the wilderness were year-round. Why did God say to do this right after Yom Kippur? It's not only to make us have to run straight from Yom Kippur into another Yom Tov, into another celebration, but rather, shetzarich liyot navanad mibetol ha-sukkah, because we're supposed to wander from our houses into the sukkah. V'dome le-galut, it's like exile, shumechaper nami avonot, which atones for sin. So I don't understand. How do you reconcile these ideas that we are experiencing exile, that we are experiencing punishment, with the idea that in the sukkah we're close to Hashem? So I think they can be reconciled, because I think both sides are true. Sitting in the sukkah is not necessarily a dichotomy, a split between intimacy with God or distance from God. It's a process. Sukkot is what you make of it. It starts out as galut. It starts out as exile. And perhaps there is atonement in that. We're shocked when we leave our homes to go into the cold. Remember, I'm speaking to you from Toronto. Perhaps it's somewhat damp. The lighting isn't as good at night. There might be bugs around. There might be bees around. Most of all, we're out of our element. We're embedded in unfamiliarity. It's a form of exile. That's what it's like, the shock of going from a comfortable home into a sukkah, from a familiar environment into something unfamiliar. However, we are meant to live in it with emunah, with faith in God. As Rav Tzedakah Kohen wrote in Tzidkat HaTzadik, Kufayin Aleph, V'yadua, D'tam sukkahu hachisayon b'Hashem v'abitachon bo. He says it's known that the reason for sukkah is faith in God and trust, sheltering in God and trusting Him. What we're doing effectively is emulating the Jews who left Egypt. As terrible as Egypt was, it was familiar. Not comfortable, not enjoyable, slavery. Nonetheless, it was familiar. And we left that and learned to trust God in the Midbar, in the wilderness. That's the process we go through on Sukkot. And so we merit the Sukkah as a divine cloud of protection. May we merit to complete that journey this Sukkot and earn the promise recorded in the Baal HaTurim in Parshat Emor, that sitting in the sukkah earns a chuppah with God. He says, "Keneged shivat hayamim sheYisrael yoshvin basukkah," parallel to the 7 days that the Jews sit in the sukkah, "Zochin lezayin chuppot." We merit 7 chuppot. And he goes on to name the 7 chuppot, the 7 clouds of glory that the Jews had in the wilderness, 6 on each sides of the cube, and then 1, the one that leads us. May we merit to sit in a sukkah, which comes to be one, if not of comfort, one of a feeling of being close to Hashem, of having faith that Hashem is protecting us. And since I'm actually filming this video before Yom Kippur, may we merit a Gemar Chatima Tova.